You know, one of the things we may unintentionally forget is that Jesus is a Jew, and that the early church primarily consisted of Jews. But as the church began to spread, it spread into Gentile communities, those that did not come from Jewish roots or practice Judaism. So throughout the book of Acts, you kind of see this struggle of where should the early church focus and fix, well, its attitudes and how it should embrace the culture as the church began to move forward. And in Acts chapter 15, there's this amazing council that comes together, and there's a letter that's written. Let me read to you this letter, because it does bring together that division that was happening between Jew and Gentile. And there's a lesson for us in this little letter this morning. Acts chapter 15, starting in verse 23, this is what it says. "This letter is from the apostles and elders, your brothers in Jerusalem. It is written to the Gentile believers in Antioch, Syria, and Cilicia. Greetings. We understand that some men from here have troubled you and upset you with their teaching. But we did not send them. So we decided, having come to complete agreement, to send you official representatives, along with our beloved Barnabas and Paul, who have risked their lives for the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. We are sending Judas and Silas to confirm what we have decided concerning your questions. For it seemed good to the Holy Spirit and to us to lay no greater burden on you than these few requirements. You must abstain from eating food offered to idols, from consuming blood or the meat of strangled animals, and from sexual immorality. If you do this, you will do well." See, I find that there's so much packed within this little letter to these early believers who were struggling with religious and cultural dynamics. But did you recognize what the apostles, what the leaders, what the elders did there? They said, listen, we're going to send to you trusted leaders, and we're not going to lay any burden upon you that the Holy Spirit doesn't already lay upon us. Abstain from sexual immorality. Abstain from any kind of connection to idolatry. And see, friends, listen to me. This morning, I believe the Lord has that same call upon our lives, to walk together with Him in purity, also in solidarity of heart, where we live for the Lord physically, spiritually, emotionally, relationally, as unto Him in purity. So this morning, be encouraged. The Lord doesn't want to lay heavy burdens upon you. He wants you to walk with Him in purity, solidarity, enjoying the wonderful relationship He's given. Because you know what? Jesus, He's the one who restores your soul and rebuilds your life. There's no one better than Jesus to make your life all about.